Naval chiefs have warned of an upsurge in Russian military activity near Britain, after Theresa May watched RAF fighters show how they intercept Kremlin jets. Royal Navy vessels were deployed to shadow Russian warships along the UK coast over Christmas amid rising aggression by Moscow. The missions came after the Prime Minister saw firsthand how Typhoon jets roar into the skies to challenge Russian bombers threatening British airspace. HMS St. Albans set sail on December 23 to monitor the Russian Admiral Gorshkov frigate and tracked its progress through our areas of national interest. The British warship is the current fleet-ready escort, on 24-hour alert to intercept potential threats to UK waters. The Navy said there had been a recent upsurge in Russian units travelling through UK waters, including on Christmas Eve when HMS Tyne was called to escort a Russian intelligence gathering ship through the North Sea and the English Channel. A Wildcat helicopter from 815 Naval Air Squadron, based at Naziovitan, was also scrambled to track two other Russian vessels. The voyages near and in British waters came after Mrs. May spent December 22 watching typhoons carry out a 320 mph mock intercept of her RAF plane off the Norfolk coast. She personally agreed to allow the Air Force's Voyager Airbus A330 to be the target of Top Guns carrying out a crucial training sortie while she was on board. Observers suggested the PM's decision to authorize the practice interception of her own plane as she returned from visiting British troops at RAF retiree in Cyprus could trigger a retaliation from Vladimir Putin. The PM boasted, "Witnessing the unique skill of the RAF at first hand is an absolute privilege and once again demonstrates that the British armed forces are the finest in the world." It was seen as a provocative show of force which would have sent a stark warning to the Kremlin, and risked a backlash from the Russian premier. Following the deployment of the Type 23 frigate St. Albans, Defence Secretary Gavin Williamson said he would not hesitate in defending our waters or tolerate any form of aggression. He added, "Britain will never be intimidated when it comes to protecting our country, our people and our national interests." St. Albans commanding officer, Commander Chris Ansell, said, "My ship's company take great pride in serving Great Britain and the role they play dealing with both the routine and unexpected. Missing parts of Christmas and New Year with our families is never easy, but it is absolutely required as part of our duty to keep Britain safe all year round." Christmas Eve saw some particularly exciting and bumpy weather, with some of my newer sailors getting used to their sea legs, but we have made sure the job was done and I will get my team back home as soon as possible. Our families have been incredibly supportive and even sneaked a few presents into our bags so we had things to open, resulting in a great Christmas day at sea.